Our goal is to generate a plane like this with C#. In this tutorial, I'm gonna assume you know basic terminology in mesh generation, that is, vertices, triangles, UVs, normals. If you have problems with that along the way, I'm gonna refer on some theoretical sources on the topic in video description. Now, make a new script and remove default bullshit. I'm gonna make two classes. It's not necessary to divide it like that, but having a separate hierarchy for procedural shapes will come in handy in larger projects. Abstract procedural shape and plane deriving from it. In abstract one, I'll store mesh that we will be creating. In constructor, I'm just gonna assign it. The specific constructor for our plane mesh will pass the mesh object through base constructor and take size parameters that will define the size of our plane. If you don't know what's happening with base keyword, constructors, abstract class, or general inheritance, then get your shit together. You need to know object-oriented programming, read some basics about it. Now, as for actual mesh generation, I'm going to separate this process into three parts: generating vertices, triangles, and UVs via appropriate functions. I'm also going to specify containers for those structures. Vec3 array for vertices, int array for triangles, and vec2 array for UVs. Let's start with verts. We need to iterate over each vertex of our grid. I'm going to do it with two for loops, one looping along y-axis, second one along x-axis. We need to index variables in the array this way to go through each vertex. I'll assign new position in space to each vertex, as well as switch y-coordinate with z, as Unity treats y as height. Assigning position is up to you. You can also add some variables for scaling or offset. And fuck, I also forgot to initialize the array, so let's do it now. Number of vertices is just equal to size x times size y. Next up, triangles. So the tough stuff begins now. We need to connect vertices to form triangles. How do we do that? Let's do it with example. 3x3 plane. We need to create two triangles for each vertex, besides the last column and last row. So in this example, 4 vertices times 2 triangles. In code, we're gonna loop through all vertices, except we're gonna skip the last row. We also need to skip last column. So to do that, I'll use modulo operator to ignore the last vertex of each row. Now we need to create two triangles. I'll name our triangle vertices ABC to make it easier to visualize. A will be equal to current plane vertex, B will be the vertex in next row, and C is gonna be vertex next to B. Pretty simple, right? Now let's fill the array with those indices. Triangle array contains vertex indices, so for each triangle there are 3 integers. Let's move to the second triangle. I'm gonna reuse our ABC variables. A stays the same, B changes by 1, and C is just incremented A. Assign those and increment our vertex counter by 6 indices that we have just written. And of course I forgot to initialize the array, fuck. We need the number of vertices, subtract last row and column, but we need to add 1 because corner vertex is in both last row and column. Times 2 triangles, times 3 vertices per triangle. Bang, we're done. UVs, let's keep it simple and assign XY position, same as in vertices. I won't go much into detail here. Target texture will be simple downward projection along the Z-axis. Lastly, assign our mesh structures. So let's try it out. I'm gonna use awake to obtain mesh filter component and use it to pass our mesh to plane class constructor. With size, I'll start with 3x3. Create new game object, add our script, mesh filter and mesh renderer. And we've got a black plane. What the fuck is that? If you switch to wireframe, you'll see that everything seems fine. So what's with that color? We need one last thing, and that is to recalculate normals for shaders that use those normals to calculate lighting. We do it with functions applied by mesh class. I'll quickly throw in variables for changing size from the editor to test out different sizes for our plane. Seems to work fine. Now let's test our UVs. I've got a checker texture and adequate material. And it works fine. If we comment out the UV assignment, we can see that our texture is not applied correctly. So always remember about UVs when dealing with textures. That's it, see ya!